Hey guys, thanks for watching my videos about Peyronie's disease. In the comments I received a couple of questions regarding another form of bent penis, Chordee. I hope this video will clarify some of the misconceptions about Peyronie's disease, because Peyronie's disease and Chordee have nothing to do with each other. Hi, my name is Stefan Buntrock and I'm a urologist. In one of my previous videos, I talked about an inflammatory disease of the penis which causes the penis to bend with time. The name of the disease? Peyronie's disease. Check it out, Peyronie's disease occurs more often than one would think. In the comment section, I noticed that some of the younger viewers went like, "Oh my god, I might have Peyronie's disease, help!" Most probably, this is not the case, I can assure you. It's a disease that occurs later in adulthood. Most patients are in their 50s. It may also occur earlier, especially if related to sexual trauma, but in my practice, I might have seen one patient younger than 40 and it wasn't really certain. If the penis bends with erections at young age, it's generally a birth defect, which is called Chordee. Because the defect is only visible at erections, the problem may go unnoticed until early adulthood. What happens is that during development of the fetal penis, more elastic tissue is built at the top half of the penis. Why this occurs is unknown. The effect is a typical downward bending of the penis at erections. Because of the excess of elastic tissue at the top, the bottom becomes relatively too short, so the penis starts to bend downwards. It may also bend sideways, which accounts for a quarter of the cases, or a combination of sideways and downwards. Upwards occurs only in 5%. Chordee is in many cases diagnosed early in childhood because it often has a brother or sister disease that often shows up simultaneously. This one is called hypospadias, another birth defect. In hypospadias, the urinary opening is not at the tip of the penis, but on the underside. Where exactly is highly variable from person to person. This is something that needs plastic surgical correction, and Chordee will be fixed at the same time. It is therefore important that circumcision is avoided in these boys, because the foreskin may be needed when it's time for the procedure, which is usually before age 2. Does Chordee pose a problem when first detected in adulthood? It depends. Theoretically, it could be a reason for discomfort during sexual activity, especially when the angle of the curvature exceeds 30 degrees. More than 60 degrees is very likely to interfere with sex life. I have an anatomical model here and a measuring device. 30 degrees looks like this. And 60 degrees is this much. In my other videos, I talked about shockwave therapy and how I use it in Peyronie's disease. Shockwaves are not the treatment needed here. In Chordee, there are only two possibilities. If not repaired in childhood, one has to evaluate if the angle poses a problem. If not, leave it. It won't harm you or your partner. If yes, surgery is the only way to treat it efficiently. Hope that made things clearer for you. Subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, leave your comments down below, and I will see you in my next video. Bye bye.